How much exercise is too much? A new study suggests high-intensity interval training, or HIIT, is beneficial for health, but it also can disrupt fitness performance. Joining me right now is NYU School of Medicine Associate Professor and Metropolis Pain Medicine Director, Dr. Devi. Dr. Devi, it's great to see you this morning. Thanks very much for joining us. So what do you make of these researchers finding the positive as well as negative effects of HIIT?
Well, we know that as you exercise more, that you can get benefits from that, of course, in terms of fitness. But it seems that with HIIT, that if you start to exercise more than 3 times per week, that you start to get decrements or decrease in performance, and you start to see other problems going on. Now, HIIT, or high-intensity interval training, a lot of people find that very popular. So the difference between that and other exercise is that generally it requires less time. So the idea is that you're exercising really intensely for a few minutes at a time, so generally 4 minutes maybe maximum of 8 minutes, and then you rest for a few minutes, you exercise again really intensely, rest for a few minutes, and then you do that a couple times a week, so maybe up to 3 times a week. And what these researchers did is that they had people do it twice a week and then maybe 3 times a week the following week, and then they had them do it up to 5 times a week. But when they started doing it 5 times a week, they really started to have decrements in performance. So they started to have problems. Now, HIIT training is more popular here because it requires less time. So traditionally, people have said, experts, public health experts usually have said that they want people to try to exercise 3 to 5 times per week for 15 to 30 minutes at a time, which requires a lot of time, which is hard for most people to do.
So what are your recommendations, Dad? Are there different recommendations for those who might have vulnerabilities, heart issues? How do you continue these intense workouts but limit the negative effects?
Right. So HIIT training is generally for people who are healthy to begin with. So you want to talk to your doctor first. Now, aside from this study, generally, HIIT training is good for people who are healthy to begin with. I mean, others can do it, but you want to prime yourself first. You don't want to just start out by doing high-intensity exercise. You want to do some regular exercise for a while so that you're somewhat fit to begin with, and then start doing the high-intensity. Now, the issue here is that you can get into overtraining. That's the problem with doing too much of the exercise. Now, overtraining, what are the symptoms? Symptoms are that you start to feel really fatigued. Now, anyone who does exercise and they're improving and they're getting stronger, they may feel fatigued at first, or they may start to feel sleepy and a little bit sore. So how do you tell the difference? I mean, as you're getting stronger, you know, you do break down some muscle fibers and then they regrow. That's how you get stronger, that they come back together stronger. But if you're overtraining, what happens is that the mitochondria, which are the energy generating sort of machinery in the muscle, they become less efficient. And so what happens is you start to lose some of your performance. It becomes more difficult to actually exercise, and you start to have problems with your metabolism. So your sleep gets disordered, your hormones become more disordered, and then you start to have problems in terms of getting more infections. So overall, you start to become more unhealthy. So if you notice that as you exercise more, you're becoming worse overall, then that can be part of something called overtraining syndrome. Now, most people who do HIIT training versus regular traditional exercise, they tend to be more competitive people. So usually what happens is as they're overtraining, rather than resting, which is the treatment for this, resting or relative rest, they actually train more to try to compensate, and that can exacerbate the problem.
All right, Dr. Devi, great advice from you. We appreciate you joining us this morning. Thank you so much, and we'll see you soon.
So great to see you.
Thank you. Coming up. All right, you too.